Greetings, fellow Oaklands. Welcome back to more Delta Force. Today we shall be tackling Carrion, and the objective is pretty simple: destroy the enemy convoy and capture the officer commanding it. So we need to be mindful not to kill the commander, and I hope, he's not inside one of the trucks or cars that we need to blow up. So anyway, we'll go address that right now, and Snake Eyes seems to be an infiltration mission, of course, which is just boils down to killing everybody anyway. But yeah, for today it's Carrion, and let's go ahead and read the mission briefing. Again, it seems to be in the shape of a astrological, you know, how do I put this? A star constellation. I forget my English these days, I'm sorry. Yeah, mission: destroy the enemy convoy, disengage objective blast, and capture the commanding officer. Capture the officer commanding it. Execution: your insertion point is 200 meters west of convoy start base. Okay. Quite far away from my buddies at this point. Shadow the objective out of the base until you reach the designated ambush point. Do not engage the convoy before it reaches the ambush point. Doing so will alert the base, which could deploy enough men to compromise your ability to complete this mission. Eliminate all personnel and vehicles in the convoy except the 4x4. Your mission, should you choose to accept it, will be a success once all enemy soldiers escorting the convoy are neutralized and all vehicles except the 4x4 are destroyed. Expected enemy forces. Alpha team has been observing the enemy base and the convoy's preparation for departure. They report that the enemy base is heavily fortified with over 20 soldiers on station, as well as multiple two-man perimeter patrols. According to Alpha's last report, the convoy consists of multiple vehicles with an escort of 10 to 20 soldiers on foot. Allied support. Okay. Alpha team is currently on site observing the base and convoy. Once you have been inserted, they will withdraw from their current position and move to a coordinated firing position for the ambush. They are currently on site as I'm being briefed. They have been there for quite a long time. Impressive. Situation: based on information recovered during the recent hostage rescue attempt, Joint Staff Intelligence C2 has identified one of the hostage takers as an officer in the CNLF. I think Chad Liberation Front. In order for Delta Force operations to continue within Chad, the government of Chad has agreed to expand the mandate of Delta Force operations so that broader actions can be taken to defeat the CNLF and recover the hostage. With the expanded mandate in place, authorization for the capture of the hostage taker has been issued. Joint Staff Intelligence has intercepted radio transmissions that suggest this person will be in a convoy leaving the CNLF base, approximately 150 kilometers north of Mao. That name sounds Chinese for some reason. Now, I do want to... I don't know whether I want to keep this gear or not, because I'm pretty sure that my secondary weapon will be a claymore. Now, what I can advise is to not take the satchel charges. I don't know whether the claymore charges have the same bug or not, but there's a bug in this game where satchel charges and claymore charges disappear once they're thrown. So what I've been advised to do is to take laws instead. And I'm wondering whether I need to take law or whether I can just take double load ammo and go for the M4, because that gives it a lot, and I mean a lot of rounds. So I mean, this is not a bad gun at all, this is a great gun, but it just doesn't have the zoom capabilities, which sort of, you know, help quite a lot. So sidearm, I'll be taking the Spec Ops 45. Or maybe this. I mean, it is pretty good, and it would seem that stealth might be essential on the first half of the mission. So yeah, might as well take that. Let me try with this, and if things don't work out that way. See, one of the benefits of using this gun is that normal bullets will destroy cars anyway, but this also has grenades, fragmentation grenades for you to use. So, I mean, by default it gives you 18, and if you choose to take the, double ammo load, you'll actually get 24 grenades, so that's a lot of grenades. Except, you know, in comparison to the two rockets that I get with the law. Of course, they're rockets and they've got like an infinite amount of range, but this also does the trick. I mean, if I'm zooming in, I can probably like shoot cars and blast them. So yeah, let me try with this, and if it is not possible, then I will attempt with the LMG and the law. Again, for, I don't know, the umpteenth time maybe. Retry number 4. Sorry, my bad. But yeah, it's a long hike, and things don't always go in your favor. Oh my god. Kill me already. Now, how did the base get low this time around? I did the exact same thing that I've been doing all this while. Maybe it was because I ran on top of this hill, and not, you know, underneath the ditch here.
Bravo King 6, package is moving.
But yeah, while this guy's casually walking, you can literally, you know, knife him in the back. Okay, I don't know why I was bobbing up and down like that, but yeah, whatever works your boat.
Be advised, I got eyes on the convoy, multiple trucks, one Land Rover to the front.
One Land Rover to the front. Gotcha.
This is King 6, package confirmed in the Land Rover. Repeat, package is in the Land Rover.
Package confirmed in the Land Rover. And I'm just gonna play it safe and let them pass before I decide to, you know, move forward and attempt anything else. But damn, the last time was a long hike. Was a long, long hike. And I don't know if the final, you know, objective marker, the red one at the right hand side, whether that is a whether that is the ambush point, or whether that is actually the, how do I put it, the extraction. But whatever it is, it's that can't be the ambush point, but it's taking us all the way around, like making us take the long way around. For what reason, I have no idea. So from the looks of it, I don't think you can get fall damage in this game. And but one of the reasons that I do not prefer this weapon is that it does not have the zoom capability that other weapons do, the snipers and the M4 specifically. But anyway, I'm just gonna try and follow this convoy from behind, hoping to not set off any alarms this time around. And yeah, let's see how it goes. The previous time around I tried and I got, you know, hit multiple times and died on the battle in the field of battle. Died a glorious death according to some cultures. But let's see whether that is the case this time around or not. I really hope it is not, but you never know. This mission is getting sort of irritating, I'm not gonna lie. Primarily because of the way the objective markers decide that you need to finish it. So, yeah. Instead, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna not tackle the objectives at all. And, yeah, continue on to meet Bravo. Sorry, Alpha Team. I am Bravo Team. I'm just gonna wait opposite to Bravo. Because the thing about this convoy is, it's just gonna stand there and wait for me. Who saw me this time around? Was it? Yep, it was the convoy. No problem, no problem. No need to shoot at me. I'm going. I come in peace and I go in peace. Says the guy, Delta Force operator with a gun in his hand. But yeah, for now, at peace. For now, I shall not persecute you for your actions. That time should come later. Because I don't know how they noticed me this time around, but they did. And yeah, this game acts weird from time to time. It's always the roll of a dice as to what's gonna happen next time around. And yeah, that's pretty much the convoy at least has been separated, so now at this point I really do wish I had that is not my group. Those are just my friends. That is a tower. Not my friends. What am I saying? Now, the thing about this is that the high volume of firepower sort of affords you the ability to kill people. Sorry, as I was saying, the high volume of firepower with these sort of affords you the ability to damage people without the accuracy required to kill them specifically. But yeah, this mission went bad in... Oh, I'm not supposed to damage the car, I keep forgetting. That is Alpha Bomb. Now, who else is remaining? I wonder. There's somebody over here. Where are you, sir? I need to hunt you down and kill you. Because if I do not, then, yeah. There will be people who will want to kill me. I do not. Ah, that guy. Sort of sucks to imagine that that guy could have killed me. So, yeah.
Package is secure. Move to primary LZ.
And I was almost about to die there. I don't know who shot at me, but somebody did shoot at me, and I was almost about to die there. But thankfully, we have captured the colonel, and or rather the lieutenant, I suppose. And I hope I do not die at this point. Maybe it'll still consider it a win. I have no idea. No way of knowing either. But I don't think they made an animation of them, you know, escorting the lieutenant out of the vehicle. But yeah, this armored Humvee is where the lieutenant is supposed to be. I wonder where my friends are, all the way over there, at the holding at the rear of the convoy. So come on, sir. We need to take you back to the States with us. Anyway, that's the end of the mission, and let's go ahead and read the debriefing. Congratulations on the successful capture of the objective. This mission has already begun to pay off by providing needed information on the CNLF's activities throughout Chad. Although the exact location of the hostage was unknown to the lieutenant, he has revealed the location of a base near the city of Abesh, or is it Abeche, that will be thoroughly investigated. Okay, I expect to see that pop on the map now. It hasn't. Or I suppose it was supposed to pop up after this mission, but two missions got unlocked anyway. Next up is the mission called Snake Eyes. And infiltrate the enemy base camp, designated objective scene, and steal a laptop computer. So, yeah. We'll get to that the next time we return. And until then, that is it for today. Thank you for watching. Farewell. Take care. Farewell, fellow friends.